SwiftUI Scroll Views in iOS 18 have become even more powerful and flexible, making it easier than ever to create dynamic and seamless scrolling experiences. This video is the ultimate tutorial to showcase all the new features, walking you through practical examples and advanced techniques to help you take full advantage of these improvements. Whether you're building a simple app or a sophisticated interface, this tutorial will elevate your SwiftUI skills to the next level. So today we are going to learn a lot about scroll phase changes. This is a small part what I'm teaching in SwiftUI Camp, where you can master SwiftUI in 4 weeks. An 80% link is down in the description. And as you can see, this is just a small part what we are going to be learning on week 3, scroll views. Go ahead and check it out. It's going to be starting on the week of 14th of October, so only 3 seats left. Maybe there are less when you are watching this video. Go ahead and check that out if you want to master SwiftUI. Okay, so this video is the second part of a 2-part series about scroll views in iOS 18. Previously, I talked about scroll positions. And we basically made sure that we can scroll all the way up and down into a certain cell. And I just showed you how easy it is to do that with the new API. Previously, it was really, really hard to do that. Okay, today we are going to talk about a lot more functionality that has been added into our hands from SwiftUI Scroll View, mainly the scroll phase change. And I'm going to go a little bit deeper onto what exactly there are. So let's get into the code. This project is basically just a tab view with two of these views. The first one is for the previous video. And for this one, we have this scroll phase view, which is basically just a scroll view with all of these colors. Okay. So first of all, we have our view modifiers. I'm going to talk about them, but I want to make your life even easier and to be able to use these new features even easier in SwiftUI. So we are going to do a little bit more work today. So we have everything in place. So you can see that we have two files over here, scroll phase change and for scroll phase change modifier. We are going to start with the scroll phase change because here I'm going to create a struct that will hold all of the information that we can get from the scroll view. So let's dive in and you will see how and what we can have access to. So let's import SwiftUI and let's create a struct called scroll phase change, but it's not going to be a view, but we are going to need an ID. You will see in just a second why we need that, and hashable basically to just see get access to all the visible cells, which is really amazing. And then this has to be equatable because we are going to listen to the changes of this scroll phase change. Okay, so what do we need right over here? Well, there is this new scroll phase in SwiftUI, and we will get the old phase and the new phase. So let's create that one, and that will be of type scroll phase. And then let's duplicate this, and let's have this new phase. Then we are going to get access to the scroll geometry, which is really, really powerful. Var geometry. And that is not just geometry proxy. That's old news. The scroll geometry. There we go. And we are also going to get access to the velocity. Now, what is this velocity? Well, if you scroll down, you have some, you know, speed to your finger. If you just go really fast, that has a high velocity. If you scroll really slow, it has a low velocity. And you now have access to all of that data. So var velocity, and that will be a CG vector. That's an optional. And finally, we are going to get an array of visible items. Var visible items. And that's why we need this ID right over here. Those will be of type ID. So therefore, your models have to be hashable. Okay, so now let's create a custom initializer for this with some default values. Let me just have these on a new line. And then, you know, these initializers that Xcode gives, not all in all cases are really good. First of all, we want to make this error go away, so we are setting it to ID. And then let's give default values. Equals idle. And we are going to get into the details why this is idle in just a second. And scroll geometry, we want to set this to init. And content offset dot zero, content size dot zero. And now we are getting a glimpse of what we have access to. Edge insets dot init. We're going to just initialize it with the default initializer. Container size dot zero. And the velocity is the default value should be nil. That's fine. And we have the self added over here, old phase, new phase, geometry, velocity, and visible items. Okay, so this is the data that we are going to be getting. Now, how are we actually getting it? SwiftUI Camp is the ultimate way to rapidly elevate your SwiftUI expertise, offering an immersive, hands-on learning experience in just 4 weeks. You'll explore key topics such as building views, handling data, using Codable, and mastering navigation, all through engaging Zoom sessions designed to fast-track your progress with real-time mentorships and practical projects. This bootcamp will help you become a SwiftUI expert in no time. Find the link in the description for more details. Well, there is this on scroll target visibility change and then all scroll phase change. You may add this onto your views, onto your scroll view, but I want to populate this particular model. Therefore, I'm going to create a custom view modifier, which will have, which will need this scroll phase change populated. Okay, so let's go to the other file. First of all, let's import SwiftUI. Import SwiftUI, and now we want to create a view modifier. And I can see that Xcode is helping me out right over here. Let's just see. You know, I just created the body. Most probably this is not good. Yes, and then the scroll phase. No, I don't want the scroll phase right over here. But we have our kind of structure of our modifier, scroll phase modifier. Okay, so what are we going to need over here? First of all, I'm going to set up the properties and then I'm going to create the actual modifier. Well, first of all, we need an ID type. Therefore, I need to set up this ID. Remember, we are basically going to track the visible cells on the screen. This needs to be hashable. And then I can just add var ID type, ID dot type. Then I want to have a threshold on how I want to present the visible items, meaning that, you know, it's just, if it's just 30% visible or 10% visible or half, the default is half, by the way, 0.5. So let's create that variable. That will be a double. And then I want to bind this scroll phase change that I have previously created. So add binding of type scroll phase change with an ID. Okay, we don't need an initializer, that's fine. This is what we are going to need to just link the scroll phase change that we are going to set up in our view. Okay, let me just remove that. Great. Now it's time to set up the content. Well, first of all, I want to set up an animation. Dot animation. Animation. The one with the value. And animation. Oh, I did not set up the animation. Let's just add it right over here. Var animation of type animation and optional. Okay, we just pass it along. Animation. And the value will actually be the scroll phase change. Okay, now comes the fun part. We want to access this scroll phase change. So just have this new view modifier on scroll face change. And I'm going to use the one with the context too. You see there are two, old face and new face. And this one, old face, new face, and the context. So let's use that one. And then old face, new face, context. And now what I want to do is just populate the scroll face change. So scroll face change dot old face equals old face. You know, I'm just passing along the data. Scroll face change. Let's just have, after new face, I'm going to go for the geometry. There we go. That's the context geometry, yes. Scroll face change velocity dot velocity. That's from the context again. Now, what about the visible items? Well, that's another view modifier. So let's just add that there. On scroll target visibility change. There we go. And I'm going to use the ID threshold and action. So ID type, that's the ID type, threshold, visible items threshold. Now the actions, we are going to get back here the visible items, and then I can just add the scroll face changes visible items. Okay, so this is how you populate the scroll face change, and you can use this, as you will see in just a second, on your view. Finally, let's add, you know, an extension. Let's create an extension on the view. So extension view, and let's have this func on scroll face change. Yeah, it's giving me a good suggestion right over here. Let's see, ID type, threshold, animation. Yeah, it's kind of good. Let's just see what else do I want to change. So ID type, that's fine. Visible threshold, so I'm just going to rename this visible threshold. I'm going to give it a default value of 0.5. Animation, that's fine. And then the scroll face change. So scroll face change, it's a binding of type ID, really nice. And I think the suggestion could be right. Of course, we always have to make sure and double check that the suggested is fine. Looks okay. That's fine with me. Okay, so now we can go into our view, scroll face view, and add the necessary stuff. So now all of this code is for us to have really nice data about the scroll view. So first of all, let's create a state variable. And that will be of type scroll face change. But I'm going to actually give it a value, color, of type color, initialize it. And instead of this, we want to have an equal sign. We are having an error right over here. Let me just double check. It says visible items. Well, actually, I don't want visible items on my initializer. I want that to be an empty array. So let's just go over there. Back. Yes, so I just forgot to give a default value right over here for the visible items. Okay, now this error should go away. Great. Next up, I want to display all of this data. I'm just going to add a text right over here. And let's just have maybe just present our scroll face changes visible items. Because it's so much fun. It's something new and I really like it. So visible items, scroll face change dot visible items. And if you have taken a look at, you know, just blink, maybe pause the video and go back. We have now access to the scroll face change is all properties. And then I'm also going to add in here our last visible color. And if there is a no last visible color, then we are going to, well, let's just set up the description first. And if there is no visible color, then we are just going to set up none. Okay, so currently it's set up none. This last visible color will be populated after, of course, I set it up, when it is appearing, the last visible item, in our case color, will be there. This is really great when you want to track which cells came into the view. But we're going to talk about that in just a second. Before we do that, let's just have this on on scroll phase change. So dot on scroll phase change, and let's just have everything so you can just see how it all works. ID type. Now this is color dot self. Self, because the items are of type color. You would add your own property right over here, your own, you know, your own models. Okay, next up is the visible items. Let me just see. Well, no, come on, Xcode auto completion. It's not working as I expected. So let's just have option. Yes, visible threshold. That's what I need. Color.self. Visible threshold, well, I'm just going to go with 0.3. Again, 0.5, like half of the cell is the default. Animation, I just go with default. Scroll phase change, and this is kind of the power. We are just going to bind this to our scroll phase change. There we go. And now we have access to a lot of stuff, including our visible items array. So red, blue, and green. Let's just scroll. And now we have also yellow. And as the red disappears, like the threshold, 0.3, as it disappears, now we have just blue, green, and yellow. Let's scroll further. And as 30% passed, then we have orange. Now, orange is just came up here. The 30% threshold is for the safe area instead, just so you know. That's why we have it already in there. And that's it. Also, you have all of the other stuff like the geometry reader, the offset. Go ahead and check it out. There's a bunch right over here on the old face, the new face. Of course, you want to use the new face and the geometry. It's really, really amazing. Now, finally, what I was talking about, that's last visible color. Well, as it turns out, you can't just add the, you know, to check the last visible cell on the scroll view itself. You want to add it onto the cell. So I'm just going to add it right over here. This is the on scroll visibility change. So dot on scroll visibility change. And I'm going to use the one with the threshold. Let's just have a little bit more space over here. Threshold 0.3. And then no animation, please. I just want to have the action. We have a Boolean value right over here. And let's just call this is visible. And if is visible, then we want to set the last visible color to our actual color that we have in our cell. You know, this is why we need this inside the cell, and we just actually can't put it outside of the scroll view. Okay, so now as you can see, this is red. It turned into red. And then if we just scroll down, you will see now we have purple, pink, teal. If you just scroll back, teal again, yellow. There we go, green, blue. And it's really, really nice. Now you know where the user basically scored. You can have your assumptions of what you have on the screen, which one, the last one that has been appearing. It's really, really amazing. Now, all of this and much, much more we will cover in SwiftUI Camp. It's just starting really soon, so make sure you check it out. The link for an 80% discount is down in the description.